Melee is the competitive favorite masterpiece, and Brawl is the unbalanced mistake. Or is it? Hello everyone, Cartsy5 here, and today I'm going to be bringing you a video comparing the fan favorite Super Smash Bros. Melee with the hyped sequel Brawl for the Wii. And honestly, these two games are radically different. Even though they're under the same name, Melee, of course, is the game used in 100% of competitive tournaments. However, Brawl has been mostly kicked to the sidelines now that Super Smash Bros. 4 Wii U has been out for a while. Looking at these two games, you can kind of see why Melee ended up being the fan favorite. It was the first one to come out, and the first Super Smash Bros. Game to be super popular, selling 7 million units, which is more than any other Nintendo GameCube game to date and will ever be. It's apparently faster, but I don't really notice that in casual play. However, if you're a professional, of course, it's your job to notice these things, and it works better for you. There are almost no glitches that impact gameplay, except for maybe wave dashing, which I guess it's not really a glitch, more of an exploit. But of course, it's something that isn't random, it works 100% of the time, and of course, it's a great asset to competitive play. There are also some minor glitches that let you play as characters that normally don't appear in the main game in versus mode, but of course, it's not a big deal in competitive play because no one would let you do that. Now, Super Smash Bros. Melee has a great number of characters and stages, and really has all of the characters that you really need for a Smash Bros. Game, so it doesn't feel like there's anyone missing. However, Super Smash Bros. Brawl ups the ante with characters like Solid Snake and Pit, who had his modern redesign here. And of course, Brawl adds some inventive and fun new stages as well. Now, of course, I have to address the elephant in the room that is Meta Knight in Super Smash Bros. Brawl, which is overpowered and an unbalanced Kirby character, which could be payback for Kirby being number 26 out of 26 characters in the Melee tier list. Honestly, it's banned from competitive play, so it doesn't really matter too much. However, it was an error for Meta Knight to have an inclusion and be so overpowered. And of course, this was all fixed in Super Smash Bros. For Wii U. Super Smash Bros. Melee has plenty of modes that will keep you entertained for a long, long time, but it cannot compare to Super Smash Bros. Brawl's Subspace Emissary, which is a full-on story mode for a Smash Bros. Game. And of course, they both contain the classic mode that was first introduced in the original Smash Bros. Game. But back to Subspace Emissary, there are full-on cutscenes, and it just looks great. And there are many Nintendo characters that aren't even playable in Smash Bros. That make an appearance, like Rayquaza from the Pokemon series. An interesting difference with Brawl is that it has this little Nintendo WFC logo in the top left corner, which means this is a Wi-Fi game, which lets you play online and smash it up with your friends from all around the world using those annoying and long friend codes. Now, of course, it wasn't the best. It was kind of laggy and a little bit buggy, but it was the first time it ever happened, and of course, the online mode was pretty much perfected in Super Smash Bros. For Wii U. And if you love Melee and want the extra characters and features of Super Smash Bros. Brawl, you can get Project M, which uses an exploit in Super Smash Bros. Brawl that lets you load mods and fan games, and basically, you can make Brawl more like Melee. However, it's not going to be the same. Super Smash Bros. Melee has a great art style, and so does Super Smash Bros. Brawl. What's kind of interesting about these two games is that they kind of have a more gritty and realistic take on some Nintendo characters, which is kind of interesting to see. And it hasn't really been used much recently with Super Smash Bros. For Wii U, which kind of returns to the cartoony art style. But of course, neither of those is a bad thing, because it's interesting to see different art styles used for our favorite characters. Both games have a tournament mode and a really short 4 or 5 character name limit, which I find is weird, especially since I have a 7-letter name. And it's kind of weird and a little bit frustrating, but Just a weird difference. They also both have a tournament mode, which isn't really used much, and I don't really know of another game that really has something like that. In conclusion, these are both great games that are amazing in their own right, and if you have an original Wii, you can play both with a GameCube controller and memory card, which is awesome. So I hope you guys have a great day, and thank you so much for watching. Feel free to like and subscribe to my channel if you'd like to see more content like this, and bye.